Hi students, I am Pavan, your science master. Today I would like to speak to 6th standard students. Students, in the previous class we have talked about finding the directions with a bar magnet, magnetic compass, attraction and repulsion between two magnets, like and unlike poles. The assignment that I have given for you to write a lab activity finding directions using a bar magnet. Today's learning objectives are Earth as a magnet, finding out whether the given object is a magnet or not, making your own magnet, and making your own magnetic compass. Students, we saw that a suspended bar magnet always comes to rest in the north and south direction. Why does it come to rest in the particular direction only? What force is acting on it? To understand this, we have to do an activity. To do this activity, you need the apparatus as follows: two bar magnets and one thread. The procedure to be followed is: place a bar magnet on a table in any direction and suspend another bar magnet over it as shown on the screen. The suspended bar magnet should come close to the another bar magnet which was kept on the table. And observe now. What will you observe? Observe in which direction the suspended bar magnet comes to rest. Change the direction of the bar magnet placed on the table again. Do you find any change in the direction of suspended bar magnet? Is there a change in the direction it comes to rest? What is the change? The suspended bar magnet always comes to rest in the direction of the bar magnet placed on the table. But the north pole of the suspended bar magnet points towards the south pole of the bar magnet placed on the table. And south pole of the suspended bar magnet points towards the north pole of the bar magnet placed on the table. And try to answer to this question. What happens if you remove the bar magnet placed on the table? In this case, the suspended magnet comes to rest in the north and south direction. We can say that there is some magnet below the suspended bar magnet which compels it to come to rest in that particular direction. Where does this invisible magnet come from in the place of the magnet kept on the table? Here you can understand the Earth possesses magnetic property which acts upon the suspended bar magnet. Now let us move forward to understand another sub-concept, that's finding out whether the given object is a magnet or not. To understand this, you need to do another activity. Here, to do this activity, you have to collect the apparatus as follows. You have to take three objects of same size, shape and color and a bar magnet. But you have to decide which one among them is a magnet, which is not a magnet but made up of a magnetic material or a non-magnetic material. The procedure to be followed is bring three objects one after another close to one pole of the bar magnet and observe whether they get attracted, repel or not attracted. Record your observations in the table given on the screen. After that, bring those objects close to the other pole of the bar magnet in the same way and record your observations. And what do you conclude by comparing the recorded observations? The recorded observations are change observed when brought close to one pole of the bar magnet, change observed when brought close to other pole of the bar magnet. Observe object 1, whether it is attracted or repelled. Object 2, whether it is attracted or repelled. Object 3, whether it is attracted or repelled. By the above observations, we conclude the following observations. If an object is attracted by one pole of the bar magnet and repelled by the other pole, then you can say that is a magnet. If an object is attracted by both the poles then you can say that it's not a magnet but a magnetic material. If an object is neither attracted by magnet nor repelled by magnet, then you can say that it's neither a magnet nor a magnetic material. This is how you can understand finding out whether the given object is a magnet or not. Now let us move forward to understand another concept of this lecture, that's make your own magnet. It's looking a little amazing, right? We know the magnets that are available in the market, but can we make magnets as well? Yes, of course, we can make magnet. How can we make our own magnet? To understand this, we have to do an activity. To do this activity, you have to collect the apparatus as follows. You have to take a bar magnet and an iron nail. The procedure to be followed to do this activity is take an iron nail and place it on a table and take a bar magnet and place one of its poles near on the edge of the nail without lifting the bar magnet. Move it along the length of the iron nail till you reach the other end of the iron nail. Then lift the bar magnet, bring it to the first end of the nail and move along the length of the iron nail again. Repeat this process for 20 to 30 times. Always move the magnet in one direction. Don't drag the magnet back and forth. That means back and front. You can understand by observing the image displayed on the screen. Now bring some iron nails or all pins close to the nail and observe. What will you observe? Observation. The iron filings or all pins get attracted by the nail. Like this, you have succeeded in making your own magnet by magnetizing the needle. What will happen if the nail is now suspended freely? Will it act like a magnetic compass? Let us do another activity to understand whether this magnetized needle acts like a magnetic compass or not. To understand this, we have to do another activity. The activity is make your own magnetic compass. To do this activity, you have to collect the operators as follows: the magnetized needle, cork, water, and a glass. The procedure to be followed to do this activity is take a magnetized needle, tape the magnetized needle to a light cork, float the cork in a glass of water as shown on the screen. Now add a little detergent to water to help the cork float freely. In what directions does your magnetized needle point? Observe. Your observation? It points in north and south direction. Like this, it acts as a magnetic compass. This is how you can make your own magnetic compass. Students, as of now, we have talked about Earth as a magnet, finding out whether the given object is a magnet or not, and make your own magnet, and make your own magnetic compass. Students, I hope you understood the topics that we talked now. The assignment that I am giving you is to write all of these activities in a lab activity manner. Okay, students, this is for today. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.